Kia ora and welcome to part two of this crash course series on New Zealand slang, proudly brought to you by Sarita Studios. Now brought to you by Satan Studios. Part two, Kiwi phrases and sayings. Hello, I'm Lucy, daughter of Lucifer, you may have heard of him. Emmy couldn't be here today because she's probably getting hammered, pissed, shit-faced, or as New Zealand's best musicians, Machete Clan say, on the rock. If you go to sleep, you get a pinger in your ass. But going to sleep, I'm 4 days deep. Popping bottles and I'm always causing trouble. I just put a sack over her head. What am I like? The real reason Emmy is away is because she is packing a sad, or having a tanty, which is also known as having a tantrum. In part one, Emmy mentioned the word piss, but she didn't explain its versatility, because she is a dumb bitch. To piss off means to annoy. Taking the piss is to make fun of. Taking a piss means urinating. On the piss means drinking alcohol. And if something is a piece of piss, it means that's easy. It's a piece of piss to take the piss out of someone taking a piss when you're on the piss. Try figure out what that means. New Zealand shares some slang with the Devil's Playground, or as you plebs know it, Australia. I get snake bites for fun. For instance, the word crikey is akin to saying Christ, which I am not a big fan of, obvious reasons. You'll also hear the greeting g'day, which is usually reserved for older fellas. And older Kiwis will say ta instead of thanks. Give us some money. Have you done that? Ah, so cheeky. My horns! You can pay for a replacement on ko-fi.com/Emmy Hucker, thank you. Bugger. You can use the word bugger like you'd say damn when things don't go your way. Or you can say bugger all to mean barely anything. For instance, Emmy makes bugger all from these stink videos. Bugger off. It's also very effective in getting people to go away. Some of you might call me mean for saying that, but mean is actually such a compliment. Mean here means great, excellent. You might also hear the word meanage, especially with younger kids, but I've never actually heard it or used it before.
Because you're a stupid bitch.
That's what. Hang on a minute.
No.
Be quiet. Ooh, that's gonna leave a real ugly bruise. Usually we kick off the ly at the end of really and just stick with real. For instance, I hear this a lot. Oh Lucy, that's a real nice car you've got. Oh, you're going real fast. You're real close to those people. You just hit them, are you for real?
Hey Ivy, you know that new TV show that came out?
Yeah, no, I'm not that keen on it, eh?
It
kind of stink. I didn't really like it much.
She shouldn't have done that to me.
That was so messed up.
She probably violated human rights or something. I don't know. Basically, the trick is to pay attention to the last word that they say. So yeah, nah, yeah is yes. Nah, yeah, nah is no. Yeah, nah, yeah, nah, yeah, yes.
How are ya? It's not really a question. We don't expect an answer. In fact, we even just reply with how are you back to how are you.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, good. How are you?
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah,
not bad.
Good. Good, you're good. Yep.
I just want to make the most out of the summer, you know?
Hot out.
I feel like, you know, I'll look back in winter when it's pissing down and I'll regret not going out.
Not gonna waste it.
Oh yeah, by the way, pissing down means heavy rain.
We really use the word piss a lot.
Oh, you want to go to town tonight?
Yes.
Oh, you should. Yeah.
Yes.
You want to come?
Oh, I'm keen.
Hard. Keen.
Sweet as.
Psych.
Forgot my wallet.
Don't worry. My shout.
For real.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Don't worry about it.
Thank you so much.
All good.
Nasty.
Do you want to go? Shall we go?
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go.
You want to go.
You ready?
My sleeves already rolled up.
You
wanna go. You wanna go. You want a hiding. For sake. You want a hiding. She wants a hiding.
I'm late for my appointment. I'm gonna go punch some orphans now.
But going to sleep, I'm 4 days deep. Popping bottles and I'm always causing trouble.